We settle tonight. 50% take. The family's out of town. The stoner's inside. And I need to get paid tonight.
We got a routine. I pick the jobs, you pick the locks. We pick up the prize together. That's a routine. You don't change a routine. That's when mistakes happen.
Last time on Essential Viewing Collection, we answered all your questions about Prometheus, an intricately woven haunting fairy tale where we learned that sometimes we find love in the most unexpected of places and that everything isn't always as it seems.
That's almost exactly the same description we gave for The Mist in our review of Red State, which was an intricately woven haunting fairy tale where we learned that sometimes a movie is not exactly as advertised.
Just like Red State wasn't torture porn, like everyone thought, and Prometheus wasn't an alien clone, like everyone thought, The Collector is also not a torture porn slasher movie as you might expect after reading any descriptions or watching the trailer.
This may also come as an enormous surprise considering it was written by Patrick Melton and Marcus Dunstan, the writers of Saw 4, 5, and 6.
The original trilogy.
And those movies are just
it seems like the more Saw films we make, the more difficult it becomes because, I mean, there are really only so many ways you can kill a person.
How did two guys that make diaper filling for a living make a movie worthy of being part of our essential viewing collection?
We'd like to tell you, but we kind of don't want to tell you because A Collector is a movie that you need to see without knowing anything about it. Even the simplest descriptions of the plot can spoil the twist that happens at the beginning of the movie, which is the best part, aside from the part with the razor wire.
Don't spoil it.
Right, sorry. So if you can, try to avoid any review other than this one. Keep away from Netflix, IMDb, iTunes, and Amazon descriptions, and don't look at the back of the DVD case. And don't go thinking that gives you a loophole to look at the back of the Blu-ray instead. No descriptions, no exceptions.
This is not the average thriller or horror. It is thriller. Described as being part of the instantly stale torture porn genre, The Collector subverts this unfortunate label by hiding the porn behind the dresser drawer of surprisingly original suspense thriller filmmaking. The porn happens almost behind the movie.
Unlike a standard torture porn where you watch a person strapped to a chair take a drill to the face, or a Saw-like mind game puzzle porn where you watch someone torture themselves to victory or die trying, The Collector's protagonist, Arkham Asylum, is caught up in a possibly torturous situation that he may be able to escape. In standard torture porn, the antagonist has the advantage, but this movie's protagonist is always one step ahead.
What do you expect from a world-class jewel thief? He's probably used to capoeira dancing through laser grids to French hip-hop.
In fact, Arkham is so smart the movie's antagonist doesn't even know he exists for most of the movie. The movie is spent following Arkham around a house as he narrowly avoids the clutches of the collection man.
Another way this movie one-ups the competition is by giving us a reason to care. Usually you don't give a dump about torture porn victims. There isn't enough character development or it's not the right kind. You know the movie Saw? Did you see that? Did you see Saw?
I saw Saw.
You saw? And you probably didn't care about Cary Elwes. Did you care about Elwes sawing his leg off? Heck! The leg comes off. Did you care? Leave a comment about how wrong we are about you caring about Cary.
We don't care about Elwes because he is in his situation to learn a lesson about being a cheating jerk. Arkham, on the other hand, is a sympathetic character that has no choice but to steal to support his family, and that accidentally entangles him with the equally sympathetic antagonist who just wants to collect insects and put them in boxes. This clash of the collectors is a main conflict of the movie.
The film gets all of the exposition out of the way at the beginning, starting with a credit sequence that includes a little more backstory than you might first think. The plot is then laid flat in the first 15 minutes, resulting in a considerable lack of dialogue that allows viewers to focus on the tension-filled game of cat and mouse. There's so much tension it puckers the buns. The cinematography adds to the nail-biting, teeth-grinding, spine-tingling, brow-furrowing, muscle-spasming, bowel-clenching, toe-curling, nostril-flaring, fist-grippening suspense with a close, intimate shot composition that leaves you straining to see beyond the borders of your television screen. The art direction is almost visceral, with every section of the house slathered in its own distinct color scheme. You can almost feel what the room smells and tastes like. This room tastes like gummy savers.
The tension starts with Arkin's heist and doesn't let up until the credit sequence, which features bonus shots that did not appear in the movie. It's kind of a reward for all that white-knuckling you put yourself through. It's not a very nice reward. I mean, look at this woman. What's going on there? Look at that woman. That wasn't in the movie. See, I told you. The movie's ability to create tension while adding something new to the genre is what makes it so good, despite the fact that it consistently receives poor reviews from poor reviewers who don't want movies to show you something new.
It's not that. They want new torture devices, they just don't want an original premise.
Cue The Collection, the terrible, horrible, no good, very bad sequel to The Collector. The Collection is not part of our collection, it's part of some other guy's collection. A collection of bad movies. This was the movie we expected from the creators of the worst Saw movies.
The previously intimidating and competent main villain has turned into the standard slasher flick psycho that picks off an elite team of space marines that come to hunt him down with the help of Arkin, who swears up and down he's not gonna set foot in the Collector's lair and then somehow manages to find himself stuck in there anyway.
The Collection spits in the face of the first one. It's everything the Collector isn't and everything Saw 2 is, and it makes us wonder if maybe Patty Melton and Kirsten Dunstan just forgot how to make a bad movie one time, and that's how we got The Collector.
At the after party for Saw 6, Ryan Turrett came up to me and said, Saw 6 was so good it made me hate 5 even more. And I was like, oh wow, that's a great comment.
The Collector dispensation against the Twin Perfect Essential Viewing Collection wunderbar.
Ja, es ist super cool.
Es setzt die Fotoporno Standard für alle Filme fort.
Es ist nicht Fotoporno.
Als Alan Jones sagt, Dunstan mag seinen ersten Film mit spannenden Horror keine Zeit verschwendet auf würdlosen Geschichten erzählen, sondern nutzt viele wirklich spannende Momente in dieser Angstfest.
Herr Kommen, Herren Sie, was er sagt.
Es ist so köstlich und süß. Wieder gewinnen den Verse.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen, Jeter. Auf Wiedersehen.
Bis zum nächsten Video, Freunde.
Wir sind alle voll auf Glücksmomente.